In the ongoing quest for wonderful AI-rendered images, I'm always on the lookout for ways to improve my prompts. And I came across a study, an article, that concluded that there are 14 keywords. If you use those in your prompts, your images will almost always look nicer than without those keywords. Well, that is interesting. Let's have a look at a couple of images. The image on the left is the image with the standard base prompt. Image on the right is with the keywords added. And well, if we would ask a whole group of people which image would you say looks nicer, well, maybe not everyone agrees, but I would choose the image on the right. It just has a little bit more detail, the sun is there, and yeah, I would choose the right one. Another example, a howling wolf with full moon. Well, the image on the right is just far more dramatic. I bet a majority of people would select the right image. And here is a landscape. Well, maybe this is a draw. The image on the left is not bad at all, but the image on the right has a nicer composition as on a whole. So I bet the image on the right will be selected more frequently. Watercolor painting. Again, the image on the right, the reflections on the water over here are much nicer. There's a lot more detail. Well, maybe some people like less detail. That depends. But my guess is the image on the right still wins. This is a whale spaceship. Well, in this case, the image on the right is far more dramatic and it is much more a spaceship. I would select that one. And this is Chinatown. Image on the left is the base prompt. Image on the right is with the keywords added, and it looks more cozy, warmer, more detail, more interesting, so to say. A snail in the forest. Well, the image on the left, that looks good too. It has this nice translucency and the sun. On the other hand, the image on the right with those keywords, it has more to offer, more to look at, so to speak. And one more, a girl in a street, city street. Image on the right, I think we can agree that she is more memorable than the image on the left. Okay, so what are those keywords? The 14 keywords that came out of this study are these ones. They are linked in the text with this video. Okay, I never liked these kinds of words. 8K high detail, and then again highly detailed, octane render. What does it mean? How do you know what comes out of it? It always irritated me. I want to write down in a prompt what I would like to see and not these crazy terms. But it apparently seems like it works. I like to go to these websites where people post their AI work. Just for fun, it's interesting to see what others are doing, but also for inspiration. And also with this one, Playground AI, if you click an image, then you get to see the prompt with which this image was made. When I see a long prompt like this, I'm always intrigued. What is in it and how do you know what comes out? What is the image going to look like? Well, in a previous video, we have seen that naming an artist has a great impact on how the image is going to look. But what was done over here? Even 10 different artists were named. So I don't know how you can predict what comes out, but even though the image looks nice. We also know already that if you would like have a photo or a drawing or a watercolor painting or pen and ink, that greatly influences the image. But here they asked all of this together in one prompt. Photograph, watercolor, drawing, all mixed up. You can't predict what comes out. So I always tend to hate these kinds of prompts. And then we have all these words like beautiful, detailed, intricate, insanely detailed, 8K, trending on ArtStation, again trending on ArtStation, sharp focus, intricate details, and so on. It goes on and on. Well, in my eyes, a prompt like this is just copy and paste work, and it's more being lucky what comes out than that it is, let's say, controlled. But still, I did my own tests, of course, and I found out that when you include a couple of these words in your prompt, it often gives your image a bit more pop. It comes out just that little bit nicer. So I was intrigued. I wanted to learn a bit more. I went on the lookout, and then I found this article written by Nikita and Dimitri, and that was interesting read. The article is 7 months old, and in AI terms that is almost a century, so I don't know how valid it is anymore nowadays. With the modern checkpoints, they are less susceptible to negative prompts. They often don't even need a negative prompt, and maybe they also don't need these keywords anymore. But what these two guys did is they scraped a whole lot of prompts from the internet, and they counted how many times they came across certain keywords. Highly detailed was mentioned 6,000 times. And of course, we also come across Greg Rutkowski. He has the honor of being the artist that is most frequently mentioned in AI prompts. And now they ask themselves if I would put the top 10 or top 15 of these most mentioned keywords in my prompt, would I get a better image? Or is there maybe another mix of keywords that gives an even better image? And that's what they did. They mixed up different keywords, generated images, and let the people decide which images they liked best. Like over here, we see images on the left and images on the right. And yeah, we can also see that most people will probably have selected the images on the right as being nicer to watch. And with that way of working, they found different sets of keywords. And this green dot over here, that is the bear prompt. So if you asked for a dog, then that prompt is only the dog. And that orange dot over here, that is the prompt with the 15 most used keywords. But apparently, if you use those 15 most used, that is not even the nicest image, because all these blue dots that are above it, those images were selected as looking nicer even. And this is how they found a set of 14 keywords. And these are those keywords, and not all of them have the same impact. If you use colorful background, that apparently has a very large impact on the image. Well, we can already think that to be true. If you use colorful background, your image will change a lot probably. But the other words, they all have their own contribution to improving the image. Let's just for fun have a look at a couple of these terms one by one. I generated this image with a very short prompt: photo beautiful woman dress. And this is the image that comes out with seed number 0 out of DreamShaper Turbo version 2. Then I added this to the prompt: intricate sharp details. And yeah, we get a lot of sharp details. Also, it zoomed in on the subject a bit to show us those details. So it works. I'm not saying this is a nicer image, but it did what we asked. Another one, smooth, that is one of those keywords that is in the top 14 to use. Well, what it did, DreamShaper Turbo is a very good checkpoint. It translated this to "the dress should look smooth." And yeah, that is interesting. Not necessarily a nicer image. But now this is going to be fun. If I add hyper realistic to the prompt, I bet that a majority of people would select the image on the right as being a nicer image than the image on the left. And the same holds maybe for 8K. If I add 8K, I suddenly get more details in the background and another color of dress. Purely coincidentally, probably, but anyhow, my bet is that more people would select the image on the right as being nicer. And then we have concept art. If you add that to this plain prompt, you get a nicer dress and maybe even a nicer background, a nicer overall picture. And the same holds for trending on ArtStation. So all these keywords, they tend to do something, even in a modern checkpoint like DreamShaper Turbo. And then, of course, if you add color for background, then it goes crazy. And not necessarily this is a nicer picture, but it sure is colorful. And then, then we know already if you would add cinematic lighting to your prompt, then, of course, you get a movie still. And that is, of course, obvious. And also dramatic lighting, that creates a very nice image. If you would ask 100 people which of these images do you think is nicer, the majority will probably be on the right hand side. Okay, just as a sanity check, I added a strange word. I added the word flabbergasted to that prompt, and then we do not get such a nice image. This is quite a normal plain image. It's not bad, but it did not improve much. Okay, now for the final test, I added all 14 of these keywords, and then we get on the left, that is what came out, and that is such a typical AI fairy tale piece of artwork, photograph in the middle between a photograph and art, computer art. I personally do not like that very much, so I took out the color background, and I also took out intricate details and a few other words. So I left in 10 keywords, and that is an image that I think, well, that is a nice photograph. And then I ask myself, okay, but can I do without those strange keywords that I personally don't even like? Can I just describe what I see on this image, which is a beautiful woman with a low-cut, white, shiny dress in a city street? Then this is what comes out. So this is a prompt that describes what I want to see, and well, it really did that. But I have to say, the picture on the left with the 10 keywords in, that in my eye, that is a nicer picture. So I'm almost irritated that it works, but it seems to work. So well, if you want to try it out, use these 14 keywords in your prompt. Just add them to the prompt that you already have, then just have a look if the image that comes out is a nicer image. And probably not always you like to use all 14 of them. Maybe you like to take away the colorful background, and also cinematic or dramatic lighting can have a huge impact in a direction you may not want for a specific situation. But you can play around with it. I'm playing around with it, and 9 out of 10 times the image with the keywords is a subtly nicer image than without the keywords. So the final proof of the pudding, here was a simple prompt, a lady with a suitcase trolley in a hotel lobby. On the left we get that lady, and with those keywords added, I think we can all agree that this hotel lobby on the right looks nicer. Thank you for watching. Maybe see you back in the next video. And in the meantime, have fun.